Hey everybody, it's John and Don with Freshwater Systems. Today we're going to talk about well systems and specifically pressure tanks. In a private well system, you got a pump, typically it's submersed in the well, pumping the water out for you. And the second most important component of that system is the pressure tank. A pressure tank, regardless if it's a composite or steel, they work in much the same way. Water and air is separated by a diaphragm or a bladder. In the case of a composite tank, it's actually a bladder, like a balloon inside the tank. And that's where the air goes. The water goes around the outside. On a steel tank, the water comes in underneath and the air chamber is separated by a rubber diaphragm. As water fills these tanks, that diaphragm or bladder pushes into the air chamber, and that's how the pressure increases. And that's what actuates your gauge, which in turn actuates the pressure switch to tell the pump when to turn on and turn off. Well, Don, when a well system is working and then certain things happen, like the pump kicking on and off all the time, or you lose all the water out of the tank, what are some of the things that happen with a well tank, and what are the solutions?
The primary reason for something like that would be the air charge that's in the tank. If it's too low, the pump will kick on and off very frequently and cause really low pressure in the house, and can really, in the long run, end up causing damage to the pump by having it cycle so often. But if the pressure is too high in the tank, what will happen is the tank will go completely empty and you'll have a second or two of no water coming into the house, and then the pump will kick on and start to fill the tank up again.
Not very happy if you're in the shower when that happens.
Exactly.
Well, Don, the tank pressure is based on a precharge, and how do we set that?
Okay. Well, the precharge is set based on where your pressure switch is designed to turn on, and typically the air charge will be 2 PSI below what that cut-in is. And you can tell what the cut-in is by cycling the pump, by opening a faucet in the house and getting the pump to turn on, and just watching the pressure gauge on the manifold. Your tank should have a manifold like this, and it'll have a pressure gauge. This is the pressure switch here. But as the pump turns on, you'll see where the needle is on the pressure gauge, and you can watch that and see where it turns off. So for instance, if this is a 30 to 50 pressure switch, you would have the tank precharge set at 28 PSI.
So 2 PSI below whatever the low point or low cut-in point is on your pressure switch.
Exactly. So on a 40 to 60 switch, you would have it set at 38 PSI.
So if we were going to make sure the precharge was set right, we'd have to empty the tank first.
Correct. Yeah, and the procedure for doing that is you're going to shut the power off to the pump so it won't start. You'll hook a hose to the boiler drain if there's one on the tank manifold, run the hose out of the house, turn the boiler drain on, and empty the tank. And once the tank is empty, you can check the air charge with a handy tire gauge, and you just, there's a what's called a Schrader valve on the top of the tank, and you'll just put the pressure gauge on it, and it will read pressure. On the composite tanks, they're located under a cap similar to this, and there'll be a Schrader valve as well, which you can do that. A couple things to watch for when you're checking that air pressure is if you put that gauge on there and you get water coming out of there, that's not a great sign. That usually means that the bladder or the diaphragm inside has failed and the water is outside it. So that usually means a tank replacement.
You can actually adjust your pressure settings on the pressure switch, and if you do that, be sure and adjust the precharge in your storage tank. You want to drain the tank down and then check the air pressure when it's empty, and then set that precharge accordingly, and that's going to be 2 PSI below the low set point. So if it turns your pump on at 30, you're at 28 pounds. If you adjust that switch to become a 60-40, then the precharge in your tank needs to be 38 pounds. That about sum up the precharge?
That's it. And if you need to adjust the air pressure in the tank, you can use an air compressor to raise it, or if you need to lower it, you just take the Schrader valve and take the end of your pressure gauge. Will have a little knob on the end of it, which will fit right inside there, and you can press down and let the air out until you get to the proper level.
It's also not a bad idea to check your pressure switch to see if it's right on the nose of 30-50. They do come factory set, but you know how factory settings can be sometimes. It might be off if our pre-charge is not set accordingly. And you're going to see some symptoms that's not working quite right. Well, Don, what happens to a pressure tank that would cause the diaphragm to lose integrity so water comes across?
There's a lot of different things. You talked about how the bladder expands and contracts, and over time that can cause stress on the material that is it's made out of, and it'll get a tiny pinhole leak in it. And when it's got a pinhole like that, the air will escape, and then it won't there won't be any pre-charge left at all in it. So and once that happens, again, what by causing the pump to short cycle, and when I mean short cycle, it means coming on off. Submersible pumps are water cooled, but if they're turning on and off, they're drawing a lot of current and they build heat in the motor. And when they build heat is really not great for an electric motor, and it'll shorten the life cycle of the motor. So when it's turning on and off like that, it's not a good thing for. And well pumps are expensive to replace, so. It's preventative maintenance on the pressure tank really makes a lot of sense to prevent that from happening.
And that's the most important reason you have a pressure tank. It's not only to maintain pressure in your household, but it's to keep the pump from cycling. And a cycle is every time it turns on and then turns off. So the pressure tank has a volume of water called a drawdown, and that's the difference. That's the amount of water that comes out of the tank from the moment it shuts off until it turns back on again. And that's important that the drawdown matches the output of your pump. So if you're replacing a pressure tank, always remember that you got to have enough drawdown to equal the minimum runtime for your pump. And typically a well pump that runs 10 gallons a minute or less, you're going to multiply that by one, so you got to have a drawdown of at least 10 gallons. So when you size a tank, depending upon your pressure switch, you're going to look at the spec sheet and determine what drawdown you're going to get at that pressure. So you may have to go with a 30 gallon tank, or you may have to bump up to a 40, 60, or 80 gallon tank, depending upon your pump size and that minimum runtime.
Right, and pump manufacturers want to see a submersible pump run for at least a minute, and that's where the one came in that John was discussing. And when you're looking for a pressure tank, understand that most tanks are sized by the actual capacity that the tank would hold if there was no bladder in it. So if you're looking at an 80 gallon tank, it's not going to deliver 80 gallons of water for you. That's not going to be the drawdown. You might have to dive a little deeper into the spec sheet to find out what the drawdown is. And the drawdown will change based on the amount of air that's in the tank. So at 30 to 50, that certain tank might give you a drawdown of 11 or 12 gallons of water. But if you're going to operate at 40 to 60, it might only give you 9 gallons of drawdown. So when you're purchasing a tank, dive in a little bit deeper and make sure that it's going to give you that 1 minute runtime for the pump.
Great point, Don. Great point. Well, that's all we got for today. So be sure and like our video, subscribe to our channel, and check us out on our website for all your well tank needs at freshwatersystems.com.